You still heavily kind of favor the Atlanta Reign, with the roster that they have. It's just kind of top to bottom.
I think you do, especially close, based on the fact that Birdring hasn't really been soaring to the highs that he was expected now, to last season.
Now, knowing what we do know, though, Birdring's playing quite well this season.
Yep, and also with Jaru being a less known quantity at the Overwatch League level, right? By the way, he's ruining the Reign. 12 final blows, 3 deaths for this guy, and a huge amount of damage. And he is a reason. He and Space are the ones that set up kills for Birdring along with OG's Holt. So that's what's making it kind of hard to be Master and Dogman right now. Everyone on the Reign actually has equal amount of deaths. So there's no real focus that has to be applied by the Gladiators. They're just pushing.
It's interesting where the Gladiators are a team or some other teams in the league. You're kind of worried about their damage dealers. Like, can they contend and whatnot? Or you're not worried about the damage dealers and you're worried about the other parts of the team. Like the Gladiators, like their tanks and their supports are so rock solid that you were really just worried about the damage dealers coming into the year. Like if they clicked, you thought they could really make a push for even better than their previous season's placings. I think Birdring has lived up to that so far. You need somebody in that secondary spot. Jaru looking very strong on the Ashe this far.
OG, wow! Takes a huge amount of damage. Yeah, I mean, you got to be ready for this. Look, it's Zen Batiste comps. You are going to take that kind of burst damage. So nicely done by OG, just getting out alive. But look, the Gladiators are having trouble getting him back to full health.
He's not going to be alive much longer, yeah.
And that is why pressuring your opponent's healing resources is so important. They couldn't get him back to full health at all. They didn't have burst healing. It's not available with Zen Batiste competition, so you keep the pressure up. Eventually, if you get a HP advantage, the enemy tends to crumble.
Oh, he got blown up. I mean, he had like 1 HP left. I mean, and there's no way you can bring him back from that, right? Whether it be a Harmony or Batisteals, Immortality, like there's nothing that's going to save him there.
The problem is that Immortality Field doesn't stop you from taking damage. That's the issue. So, you know, they keep OG alive at, what, 10% of his health, but as soon as that field's gone, he gets smashed.
Yeah, I mean, almost the bigger issue is, like, you could probably have kept him alive using all of those cooldowns, but you would have just given up the point right after that, right? Because you don't have any of those cooldowns to extend the fight much longer. The Atlanta Reign have a good position at that time. It would have been really difficult to fight out of.
All right, Ant Matrix on the corner is not going to be relevant for very long because the cart's moving so fast with so many players on there. Still, it gives the Reign a head start in this fight. Edison, a brief stoush with Birdring on the low ground, now looks for his next target. Being chased by Hyperspheres, you saw the damage taken, but Baby Bay finds Jaru and now has the ability to take the high ground for the attackers, and this is blazing fast time for Atlanta.
Yes, Atlanta's just running through the Gladiators now, as that'll be an Ant Matrix up top from Shaz. I'm not even sure they have anybody left to shoot through it. It's players falling left and right. Big Goose, he'll fall as well, as, man, Atlanta setting a blistering time now through Blizzard World as Shaz will eventually fall, and that's checkpoint B. 5 minutes plus to finish the map.
Edison has really come alive in the last few moments. I mean, whichever way you slice it, we are going to have extra time on this map because the Gladiators are so far behind. It is ridiculous. And this gap is not decreasing.
The Gladiators could come out with a tremendous hold here.
You don't sound like you believe it.
Well, I said they could. I didn't say it will happen, but it's possible. I mean, you have that close spawn. We've seen games where 5 minutes turns into 2 minutes, turns into no time left, and everyone's freaking out rather quickly. But highly unlikely, though.
Great flux from Space. Immortality Field had to be used there by Master, so good response. Jaru a little bit far forward here. Gets a bob off into the backbone, who is pacified rather quickly. Discord Orb and Focus Fire gets rid of him. Now Baby Bay's going to have his bob to push forward, and OG and Jaru. Jaru's lost his bob, OG's down. Baby Bay has room to work, playing aggressively here. The Reign can smell it. They're so close here, and the Gladiators just got absolutely kicked in the teeth in this round. Big Goose tries to step up and stall, but this one is going to be over in a matter of moments here. Oh my God.
That was not close at all. It's 5 minutes, 25 seconds in the time bank on Blizzard World. Has to be close to a record. If not a record, just off the top of my head. I mean, I can't think of a game where we've had where there's been that much time left at the end, as the Gladiators' defense does not exist.